Hello. In this video, I'm going to look at the sports analysis tool Strava, in particular how it calculates power, even though I don't ride with a force or a power meter.
So how does Strava calculate my personal power? Well, power is work done over time taken, and work is force times distance. So you'd need to know the force being applied by the bike. I suppose the force that the wheels apply to the road multiplied by the distance moved to get my energy use. But Strava doesn't have that data. I don't have a power meter or a force meter. But I do ride, of course. Strava records my GPS data from my Garmin watch, so it knows the time and the GPS location. And if I have an altimeter in the watch, it can also work out the altitude, or it could get that information from maps. So let's see how Strava calculates power from that information.
Well, there are a couple of components that I think Strava uses to calculate power. And the first is riding uphill. When you go up a hill, of course, you gain gravitational potential energy. You climb through a height delta H in a time frame T. And gravitational potential energy is m times g times delta h. So I will gain some gravitational potential energy, and because power is energy over time, Strava can calculate my power output just purely due to the gravitational potential energy gain. Now, I've given Strava my mass details and the mass of my bike, so it knows some of those details already. Let's take a look at some data then. So I did a climb on my bike, and when I click on the data, you can click here and export the GPX file. And that gave me this data. So it gave me a timestamp, latitude and longitude data, altitude data, and some other data, heart rate it records. And I put those data into a spreadsheet. And I'm just going to switch to the spreadsheet view now and have a look at that in a bit more detail. So I've just hidden some of those data here, but you can see we've got latitude and longitude data. Now, the first thing you need to do is calculate the interval distance. That is a formula. So it's this complex formula. I didn't write. I looked it up. It's a formula to calculate how far in meters I've traveled given the latitude and longitude data. And it leads to compare the previous timestamp to the new timestamp, of course, to know how far I've gone. So that gives me how far I've gone. But really what's interesting is the elevation change. So because it's got the altitude data in this column, I've calculated here the elevation change, i.e. from one time frame to the next, how much higher I've got. And I know the amount of time elapsed. So it records a time stamp here. And here I've calculated the interval time. So the interval time is just one time stamp subtracted by the previous timestamp, and that gives you a timestamp in days, because Excel has the standard unit of time as a day. And then I've converted that into seconds here by multiplying the time, the fraction of a day, by 24 hours by 3600 seconds in a day. So in 4.4 seconds I climbed a total of 1.20 meters. Now that means my climbing power is going to be my elevation change multiplied by my mass, about 80 kilos for me and my bike, times by g of 10 is 800, times by 1.2 meters, divided by 14 seconds, gives in that particular time frame an average power of about 70 watts. Now, sometimes I may be going downhill. So what I've done is the sections where I'm going downhill, colored red here, I have taken the climbing power, which of course will be negative, and then the climbing power up, I've just made this column only positive values of this column, i.e. it turns all the negative values into zero, and so it's working out my power that I'm outputting, and I'm not outputting any power when I'm going downhill. So I've added up all those data up until the time when I reached the top of the hill, and then that averaged out to 167 watts. So that is just an average of my climbing up power for that whole column. Let's switch back to the presentation view. So you can see my spreadsheet analysis found 167 watts. Now Strava, for the same section of hill, that's here, gets my average power at 170 watts. So you can see my estimate is ever so slightly, but not much, below Strava's estimate for my power output. And that's because when I'm going uphill at a relatively slow speed, I average 15 kilometers an hour, my power output was almost exclusively from gravitational potential energy gain. But there is a small difference, and that's probably due to the energy that I would have expended in traveling along at a constant speed, because riding along the flat would take energy. So let's do a little analysis for riding along the flat too. If I'm not going any gain in gravitational potential energy, but I still maintain a power output at the pedals, where does that power go? Well, let's find out.
So to find out how much power Strava adds on when you're traveling on the flat, I've come here to a local velodrome. I'm going to do some laps at 5 kilometers an hour, 10 kilometers an hour, and so on. And then we're going to see what Strava thinks my power output is at a constant speed. Let's go.
So I did some laps at 5 kilometers an hour at increasing intervals up to 40 kilometers an hour. Let's have a look at some of those data. This is what Strava has. So this was my 10 kilometers an hour, and Strava has estimated my average power output at 22 watts for that lap. At 15, 33, and so on. So I took various data, and then here's a summary. So you can see at higher speeds, Strava estimates my power as greater, but it's certainly not linear. Well, I just did an analysis of this data in Excel, and you can see a graph of speed in kilometers an hour against power is a nice curve. There's a reasonable curve like this, and in fact, Excel suggests that Y, i.e. the power output, is about 0.16 times by the speed in kilometers per hour squared. So that's a nice formula summarizing how power is calculated by Strava when you're riding on the flat. And here's just a confirmation of that. I've squared the speed data, and I've also converted into meters per second. And a square of the speed gives a nice linear fit between that and power output. And that corresponds nicely to the drag formula. The drag formula is a half CD. CD is the coefficient of drag, and it's a number which depends on the bike, the shape, the aerodynamic position that you're in, clothing, etc. Rho here is the density of air. A is the surface area, so if you tuck down into an aero position, A will get smaller. And V is velocity, which is squared. Now, of course, Strava doesn't know the coefficient of drag of my bike and kit or the area, so it will be an estimate based on an average riding position. So there we go. In summary, Strava estimates your power output without a power meter from a combination of your climbing power and the power of you riding at a speed. Climbing power is mgh over t, and speed power seems like Strava calculates from a formula of about 0.16 v squared, where v is your speed in kilometers an hour. Hope you enjoyed that little analysis.